MZRA Nation, Magda here. Welcome to our new series, Flying with Family and Friends.
Hey, MZRA Nation, Jason Shepherd here, MZRA.com. And as we continue in with our Flying with Family and Friends series, I have an excellent clip from, well, kind of like the archives I want to share with you a little bit. Our focus today is how can our non-flying co-pilots, that's our son, our daughter, our spouse, our best friend, someone who's not a certificated pilot yet, emphasis on yet, right, that's flying with us, how can they assist us in the event of an emergency? Now, I don't mean an emergency like that happens to me, where you talk about that, like what if my spouse becomes incapacitated and I have to land this plane? That's a subject for another day. I mean, we're flying together, we're both fine, but there's an emergency, like an engine failure. If you remember how we started the year 2021, we started strong with something called the 31-Day Safer Pilot Challenge. And I hope you had a chance to watch that. If not, I'll make sure the MZRA team links to the playlist. It's 31 amazing, amazing videos. And I'm gonna share with day three with you here today. In day three, Magda and I are flying and I simulate an engine failure. And while I'm focused on flying the airplane, I asked Magda to serve as the pilot who's helping me work through the checklist. Here I am about to make the most important landing of my life, right? Again, we're simulating it. I want to be fully focused on that. To have somebody who's comfortable enough to work through, that studied and reviewed the emergency checklist, just goes such a long way. Even in the simulated environment. Remember, we practice like we play. You'll hear me mention that in there as well. She also does a great job helping spot some traffic and everything else, because even in the simulated environment, it's still important that, hey, we're doing something out of the norm. We need to keep our head on a swivel with that. So let's go back just a few months and let's check out day three from the 31-Day Safer Pilot Challenge.
I'm gonna be the flying pilot. Magda is really gonna be helping me out as my co-pilot, eyes outside, run through the flows, the checklist, some good CRM here, as we do a simulated engine failure all the way down to landing to a grass strip. Because so often I think we cheat on engine failures. We pull the power back, we glide on down, we pick a field, we get to 500 feet, AGL, and we go missed. Very few times we take it all the way down to the ground, so that's what we're gonna do here today. So let's not waste any time, let's dive right into it. Three, two, one, here's my engine failure. Magda, would you mind running me through my engine failure in flight checklist, please?
Top left, starting with the AVCs, airspeed 70.
All right, pitching for 70, trimming for 70.
Best landing area?
Best landing area is the Williston Airport grass strip, runway 36 right here in front of me.
Checklist flow, fuel selector, both.
All right, both.
Mixture rich?
Mixture's confirmed rich.
Carpet on?
Carpet's on.
Primer locked?
Primer in locked.
Attempt restart doesn't start?
Crank, 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 didn't start.
A squawk 7700.
7700 in the box.
121.5 or any towered frequency.
All right, we're on with Wilson. Let me just make a call. Wilson, traffic Skyhawk 23 Mike Zulu right over top of the field, 3,400 feet. Coming spiraling down to the grass runway 36, simulated engine failure, Williston.
Three Maydays.
All right, and Mayday, 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 we'll pretend to say. Good.
Doors open.
All right, we'd open our doors just so it's easier to egress. Now, I need to work. Is that checklist complete? I'm sorry?
Checklist complete.
All right, super, thank you. I have got the grass strip right down here. And if you, sweetheart, can help be my eyes outside, because we're still flying.
Got runway 23 full stop for Bonanza 409.
All right, Bonanza 23 full stop. I got one down there, so that's good. And now we're just kind of spiraling and working our way on down to the grass strip. And this is where we don't do ourselves a service. We practice these simulated engine failures. We go down to 500 feet AGL because there's all these pesky, congested, non-congested area rules and regulations, and we go missed. The money is made, team, from 500 feet to the ground. You have to practice like you play. There's an old story of a law enforcement agency doing some training. They were training how to disarm an armed bad guy. And they would train with the other officers. They'd pull the gun, and the other officer would perform the maneuver, take the gun, give it right back. They'd pull the gun, perform the maneuver, take it right back. And went back and forth, back and forth. They built that primacy of how they do things. And what do you think when it happened in the real life? Officer had a gun pulled on him. He took the gun away, perfectly executed, and gave the gun right back to the bad guy. You can imagine the look on the bad guy's face. You can imagine the look on the officer's face. Eastern Final, as all of this unfolded and happened, right? Practice like you play. Practice engine failures all the way down to landing.
Hey, baby, traffic 10 o'clock?
I got it. He should be a factory. He's heading out that way. Thank you, though. Super. Good CRM we got going on here. We have to practice like we play. I'm going to keep working this thing around here. I have not added in any flaps, by the way. I want to wait until I know I have the field made. Wilson Traffic Skyhawk 23 Mike Zulu over top the field 2,000 feet, spiraling down for a landing on runway 36. That's the grass runway at Williston. They don't use the grass runway much, so that's why I'm emphasizing it so much. Okay, so let's see which camera is going to pick up the grass runway here first for you. You can kind of see it that way. I'm at 1,700 feet. Way too high for a base. But watch what I'm going to do here. It's much easier to get down than it is to get back up in this situation. So I'm going to treat this at 1,600 feet kind of like a downwind in this way. I'm going to give my engine a little clearing burst. It's very cold today. I don't want a shock cooled or anything like that. And at 1,500 feet, which AGL and MSL are about the same here, probably more like 1,400 feet AGL, I'm on a downwind. And I'm going to start treating it like a normal landing. I'm actually going to go 10 degrees of flaps. I know I have this thing made here. Magda, clear right.
Clear right.
Clear right. Let's go. And I'm turning right base. Wilson Traffic Skyhawk 23 Mike Zulu is on a right base now for runway 36, the grass runway at Williston. Full stop. Everything is looking really great using my glide techniques. Magda's my eyes outside helping me so I can focus on where I'm landing. Who here has ever landed? By the way, I'm going my next notch of flaps. This is looking good. Who here has ever landed on a real grass strip? If you haven't, you need to get out there and do it. The last thing I want you to do is your first real soft field landing to be in a situation like this. And this isn't an actual emergency, but in an emergency. The odds are already so far stacked against you, I don't need anything else stacking up against you with that. This is looking good. I'm turning final at about 800 feet, about 700 AGL, 200 feet higher than I would normally be. But I'm power off. So let's watch this here. Wilson Traffic Skyhawk 23 Mike Zulu's final 36 the grass runway, full stop Wilson. I'm actually going to be able to go full flaps in this configuration as well because we did good altitude management. Speed's looking great, right? At 68, 69?
500.
There's my 500 foot alarm. Looking good. And just going to keep this old girl coming down. Looking good.
Where is that, 1 o'clock?
I got him in sight, no factor. Thank you. Looking great as we work our way on in. Those 40 degrees of flaps are making me look good though, huh? They're out there working hard. A little bit of crosswind. And I'm gonna turn carburetor heat off because we are landing on a real grass strip. My hand's going back on the throttle just in case there's an issue here. And we, my friends, are coming in for a nice soft field landing. A little gust of wind there. And down on the grass. Not too shabby. From 3,500 feet, I think we started, all the way down to a nice, real soft field landing. Avoiding braking, letting this thing roll out, watching outside.
So there you have it, a little bit of a look back. Again, if you haven't seen the entire 31 Day Safer Pilot Challenge, links below to check that out. But how are you and your non-co-pilots working together in the cockpit? Are you watching this series with your aspiring aviators or your non-flying co-pilots as well? Leave us a comment down below this video on Facebook, on YouTube, on M0A.com. And hey, please don't forget, the Fly with Jason sweepstakes is going on right now. Flywithjason.com for an opportunity to win an all expense paid trip to Florida in November. That didn't sell you alone because Florida in November is nice to come do a flight lesson with myself. We're going to have four lucky winners. Go ahead and go to flywithjason.com to learn more about that. Have a blessed, amazing, outstanding rest of your day. And most importantly, remember, a good pilot is always learning. Have a great day, everyone. We'll see you.